Assalamu alaikum everyone, and today we are going to be talking about the E1 reaction. Now before you continue watching this video, make sure to know that the SN1, SN2, and E2 reaction videos are very important if you want to understand this video, especially E2 and SN1. So I have links up in the cards and in the description down below. Now, just like substitution reactions where SN1 is unimolecular and SN2 is bimolecular, in elimination reactions, the E1 reaction is unimolecular and the E2 reaction is bimolecular. Now, the E1 reaction is very similar to the E2 reaction, and therefore, the E1 reaction's first step is to remove the leaving group firsthand. So it just leaves. In this example, bromide is very stable by itself. The leaving group leaves, leaving a carbocation on the molecule. Now this is an sp3 carbon, and whenever a carbon loses an electron domain from sp3 to sp2, it turns to sp2 and has a trigonal planar. Now the molecule is a flat one. Now since it has a formal positive charge, a weak, very weak nucleophile like water can go ahead, take that proton, and meanwhile, the electrons from the hydrogen atom go and form a double bond on the product, and the water taking the extra proton turns into a hydronium ion, an ion. The bromide is also already lone, and the product is this with a double bond in it. So that's all there is to it. Thank you for watching. I know this was a very short video. Like I said in the beginning, that I've already mentioned quite a lot of the basics in my previous videos, and to watch them before this video. So make sure to like, subscribe if you want more videos about math and science. Please share this video to other people who might be confused in this similar subject. And thank you for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye.